In this video, we go over some example problems to see how to use the first fundamental theorem of calculus. So remember, the first fundamental theorem of calculus says that the derivative of the integral function is the function itself. Okay. So our first problem is to compute the derivative of the integral from negative 5 to x of natural log of t squared plus 1 dt. Oh boy, what a mess. If I gave you this problem, you'd never get it in a million years. Well, you might get it in a million years, but it would take you quite a while. It's a hard problem. But this problem is easy because it fits right into the fundamental theorem. Little f of t is natural log of t squared plus 1. Little f of x is natural log of x squared plus 1. And a is negative 5. The only difference between this problem and this problem and is that here we called the variable s and here we called the variable t. Other than that, they're identical. So the derivative of the integral from a to x of f of t dt is just f of x. And in this example, that's natural log of x squared plus 1. Done. Finding the integral is incredibly hard. Finding the derivative of the integral is easy. Here's one where you want to integrate from x to some other number. Well, when you integrate from x to some other number, you can turn it around. The integral from x to 10,789 is minus the integral from 10,789 to x. So the derivative of the integral from x to 10,789 is minus the derivative from 10,789 to x. So that's minus f of x. In this case, f of x is cosine to the fifth power. And we're done. We turn it upside down, you pick up a minus sign. Otherwise, it's just like the first example. In our third example, let's look at the integral of cosine of t dt. And I want to compute the derivative of that integral two ways. I want to compute it once using the first fundamental theorem, and then I want to compute it again using the second fundamental theorem. The idea is let's see why these two things are the same. So using the first fundamental theorem, this just fits into the standard framework. The derivative of the integral up to x is f of x. So in that case, that's cosine of x. Okay? That's just like problem one. Using the second fundamental theorem, we can actually evaluate this integral. We say the integral from 4 to x of cosine of t dt, well, an antiderivative of cosine is sine. So we take sine of t at x and at 4. This bar with up and the bottom means evaluate this at x, evaluate it at 4, and take the difference. It's just shorthand for sine of x minus sine of 4. So if I of x is sine of x minus sine of 4, then the derivative of I of x is the derivative of sine of x minus the derivative of 4. That gives us cosine minus 0. Okay, so either way, we get the same answer. In one case, we got the answer by the first fundamental theorem. In the other case, we had to find an antiderivative. And then we took the derivative of the antiderivative and got back our original formula.